The world's best martial artists across Muay Thai, kickboxing, and mixed martial arts ignited Bangkok. And with two ONE Super Series World Championships, ONE Warriors of Light was a night of unforgettable contests. Running an impressive winning streak, ONE Warrior Series winner Mark Aberlato welcomed Shudo Bantamweight World Champion Shoko Sato to the ONE Championship roster.
And he goes down, sweeps that standing leg of his away.
Beautiful job by Sato to control that right leg of Aberlato and sweep out the other leg.
He moves so well, Sato. Really light on his feet.
Beautiful head kick landed by Sato. Landed a straight right hand off of two lower leg kicks.
Oh, uppercut thrown in. Looked to me like it landed. Couple of flying knees, left and a right. Gets that leg nice and high up, but it was caught. And a chance for Aberlato to rain down punches from quite a height. Left hook. Sends in a right there that had a little bit more intention and a forearm that had a lot more. Leading with the elbow. You don't see that so much, like a jabbed elbow. Now the come down. Big punches coming down from high up now, and Albalado's having to cover up and not do much else. Unanswered blows, and that's enough for the referee to call it a day.
Before he claimed the ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World title, Rodtang Jitmuangnon went up against Khun Khmer Flyweight World Champion Sok T.
Sok T, who's on the rough end of it, and he goes upstairs. Rodtang gets pushed back. The hands come into play as well at the 42nd mark.
Slowly inching forward, throwing those leg kicks to just kind of pin Sok T there.
Nice left hand work. Goes body and head, Rodtang. Superb offensive work here, and he bashes himself in the chest and in the face. He's taken more punishment from himself than he has from his opponent in the last 10 seconds. These two hyper-experienced 21-year-olds.
And those leg kicks are starting to add up.
Sok T gives him a nod after receiving a left hook to the jaw. A nod of respect. Left, right, followed up by kicks. This is exhibition stuff from the Thai athlete.
Those leg kicks.
Left hand, and down goes Sok T. Oh, left hand, right kick, deep kick. Sok T comes back with something, and that's what he has to do. He's got to send a message to his opponent. Meanwhile, right and left, that leg is in big trouble, isn't it? You've got to admire Sok T's resilience here and the resistance, but for how much longer? Once again, left hand and right hand, kicks to the body as well. Again, he goes downstairs with that wonderful left hook to the body. Again, he goes left hook to the body, right to the head, kicks to the left leg.
How tough is Sok T? He's still in it. He's not backing down. He's not going anywhere.
That left hook to the body. The tree has come down. He attacked that trunk. Runs across the circle, sits atop, taps his chest and says, hey, who's number one? It could well be me.
Thai standout Pong Siri Mitsatit was determined to make a statement in front of his countrymen as he faced Filipino Robin Catalan.
Pong Siri Mitsatit's got good defensive wrestling, but how is he going to handle this first takedown here? Well, immediately, Robin Catalan jumps on the back of Pong Siri Mitsatit, gets one hook in, slides that second hook in. Now he's looking to rear naked choke to play the leg game here. And he drops down and he attacks the leg. This is what he wants.
Oh, that's going after the heel hook. We've seen him win multiple times this way before.
But a good job by Pong Siri Mitsatit to avoid two bad positions right there.
Right hand from Catalan, but he was the one that went to the ground.
And take Robin Catalan down. It was the knee again.
But it was the rib, surely. That was high enough. And the knee did all the damage. It landed flush in the ribs. And the second that it landed, Catalan did not want to know anything more about it.
Savas Michael had quite the task in his ONE Championship debut as he courageously squared off against multiple-time Muay Thai world champion Singtong Noi Portelakun. Michael opened the proceedings with a stiff jab, which immediately caught his rival's attention. Michael unleashed his fierce body punching arsenal and punctuated his combinations with a left hook to the body at every opportunity. The first clinch of the contest saw the youngster score another big tactical victory when he dumped Singtong Noi to the canvas. Both men were happy to trade hard shots, but Michael's punches were crisper and faster, which meant they found the target more often. In particular, it was an accurate left uppercut left hook combination that rattled his foe's jaw. In the third round, the Thai hero charged forward with hard punches and landed some sharp elbows in the clinch. He moved forward to chase Michael, who looked like he might have used up most of his energy reserves. Michael gritted his teeth and fired back with punches. Despite his fatigue, he seemed to put a final stamp on the match when he went under Sing Tong Noi's checking leg to sweep him to the canvas. Sing Tong Noi's late rally made it even more entertaining, but Michael's dominance in the first two rounds shined through, earning Michael the unanimous decision win. In a bantamweight kickboxing showdown, top King Muay Thai world champion Zhang Chenlong put his skills to the test against Panikos Yusuf.
Should be a very high-paced technical battle.
Oh, started nicely. Yusuf got that jaw nicely tucked in. Looks as if he means business. That was a couple of nice left hands. Zhang is switching stances, occasionally southpaw, occasionally orthodox. Oh, spinning back kick. A nice right hand, or swinging left hand. The tapping of wood on wood, signaling 10 seconds left, and Zhang starts to unload. Left hand, right hand, left again. Nice left hand. Couple of nice left hands, Mitch, there. Judges have got a tough one on their hands. Oh, right hand sends Yusuf back, and his head bounced off the canvas. Zhang comes piling back in, just looking a little bit befuddled, sends in a kick, but takes another good left hand. He goes down for a second time, and for a second time, bounces back up immediately. Take a little bit of time to take a moment, but again, the punches come in. There's still 36 seconds left. If Yusuf goes down one more time, it's all over.
Zhang Chenlong trying to show that, you know, he's trying to close it right now. He's trying to get another knockout because he knows one more knockdown, that's it. But Panikos Yusuf, being the adventurer that he is, he's trying to close that distance and get inside the clinch, but Zhang Chenlong's giving him no space to breathe.
Yusuf is also cut. We're in the final 10 seconds. The referee pulls them apart. Flying knee, looking for that third, a decisive knockdown, but it's not going to come. The bell has gone. Yusuf smiles at his opponent.
Red corner,
mixed martial arts veteran Adrian Pang took on the tough challenge of Kazuki Tokodome's sharp and precise striking.
It's a cautious start from these two. There's that first look for that takedown, and Pang just bounces back up.
And just like that, Pang's able to bounce back up.
Left hand from Adrian Pang. Eats four left hands, and then he gives two back. Great stuff. Oh, right hand just nudged him off balance for a second. That one landed more solidly. 28 seconds of this opening round. Nice right hand from Adrian Pang. Left hand from Adrian, and that set his opponent sideways. Another one. Oh, right and left from Tokodome. Long arms he's got, hasn't he? And that's another good one too, and Pang just wipes his eye. That injury that was incurred in the first round might be bothering even more now. And it's a bit of a mess now, isn't it, Pang's face? And the referee has waved this one away. Olivier Costa has seen enough, and straight away, Japanese athlete crosses the cage to waste no time in congratulating his opponent on a bout well contested.
Peter Boust utilized a devastating striking attack to earn a knockout victory in his one championship debut against Japan's Kota Shimoishi. From the start of this lightweight mixed martial arts clash, Boust was looking to use his considerable height and reach advantage to keep his 31-year-old rival at the end of his strikes. The Japanese veteran went for a takedown, but Boust stuffed the attempt and then dropped him with a straight right. Once Shimoishi fell to the canvas, Boust swarmed on him for the finish and delivered a trio of explosive knees. In the co-main event, history was made as Muay Thai world champions Petchdam Petchyindee Academy and Elias Mahmoudi battled for the inaugural one flyweight kickboxing world title.
The barrage continues, and now we're erupting.
Petchdam back, trying to throw big shots. Petchdam's trying to answer, but that range is so, man, that's hard to deal with. Look at those kicks. Petchdam's got a huge left kick. Pay close attention to it, but Mahmoudi does not seem fazed by it.
Oh, good left hand from Petchdam. That landed flush. Left hand again. right hand from Mahmoudi was crisp, and it shook the face of his opponent. Final moments of this opening round. Oh, nice right hand from Mahmoudi. Counters very well and sends in combinations. A very solid right hand.
Right hand glued to the side of his head as he spins there.
Oh, holding and hitting. Beautifully executed by Petchdam. Rushing forward, throwing a right hand, and two more. Petchdam doesn't seem once to have been bothered by the heavy artillery, and that was another solid right from Mahmoudi.
Yeah, Petnam's wearing these shots extremely well. He's got an ironclad chin. Look at that combination. Jumps in with a skip knee, lands the right hand.
All of Petnam's work mirrored by the fans here at the Impact Arena with cheers of joy and support. But at the moment, their man is slightly behind, I fancy.
That's two good left hands landed by Petnam.
Lunges forward and lands a short right hand, and Petchdam lands a super left. But Mahmoudi came back with three more huge punches just before the bell rang.
Man, Petchdam is wearing these. Oh, beautiful back fist.
Oh, left and right from Petchdam was solid.
Oh, nice timing there from Petchdam to avoid the wheel kick and then land the body shot.
Good left hand from Petchdam, and he follows up with another. Mahmoudi backed up against the circle wall, eats another good right hand from green-haired Petchdam, who keeps on going.
Oh, that hook. Oh, Mahmoudi answers right back.
Left hand was big, and the crowd appreciated that, but Mahmoudi countered very well with the right.
Great defense by both these guys, Steve. Great defense.
Oh! But it gives you an idea of Mahmoudi's ambition, doesn't it?
Oh, low blow.
That's central. Just looking over at Mahmoudi, and the chances of him continuing, to me at the moment, don't look great.
Our athlete is unable to continue due to an unintentional illegal strike. We will now turn to the judges' scorecards. The one flyweight kickboxing world champion, Petchdam
gets the belt, and he is your champion.
Two-time Lumpini Stadium Muay Thai world champion, Super Lek Kiat Mu 9, unleashed a full arsenal of sensational strikes to score a stunning win at home in Bangkok against Portugal's Rui Botelho in a thrilling flyweight Muay Thai clash.
Big start from Super Lek, and the crowd are loving it. Oh, back punch! Overhand right, just as Botelho just tried to shorten the distance. It landed quite high up on the head, but it dropped him instantly. Right hand from Botelho was a nice one as Superlek was coming in. Flying knee as Olivier Cost supports them and brings them together. 5 seconds left in this opening round, and it's been wonderful action. Looking for the spinning back elbow there, Botelho. That elbow again, Mitch. A wonderful strike. He comes up with a fist as well. Superlek is giving it everything. Or a right hand as well, followed up with a foot. Every strike he throws is being cheered by the home fans here. Botelho battling not only his opponent, but the entire Impact Arena, seemingly. Superlek ushers him in, says, come on, let's have a battle here in the center of the circle. Botelho gets pushed back to the circle wall there with a super kick. Big right hand just brushes the jaw. Just gets a little bit untidy. Enjoying the final moments as Superlek goes to war again with that right leg. And again, he's beckoning Botelho in, just teasing him, annoying him. Oh, what a wonderful kick that was to the jaw. Follows it up with another one, and Botelho might be in a bit of trouble here. The elbow to the head as well. Good work to the body from the Portuguese. Couple of left hands. So Botelho knows he's done some damage. Is it enough, though, when the judges tot up their cards?
Red corner, Super
Janet Todd scored her first ONE Super Series win in style as she overwhelmed Wong Chin Long in a women's atomweight kickboxing bout. The IFMA Pan American Muay Thai champion utilized a simple but punishing formula to score a TKO finish in the second round.
So now she's got to time it. She's got to utilize it very, efficiently.
High guard that Janet has, protecting her face at all times as she approaches her opponent.
Strikes that they're throwing between combinations. Beautiful jab to a body kick there by Todd. You can see Wong Chin Long is just taking, eating a lot of these jabs. And this is what Todd said she wants to do. She said she wanted to attack the body, attack the legs.
Beautiful hook to the round. And Wong's gone down. And the referee will take a good look at that.
The hook, leg kick, drop Wong. Oh, and she starts wrapping it around the head, goes shin to chin.
She'll have to really go some now. Is Wong gonna survive and get a minute's respite?
Wong's gotta move, and she
three knockdowns, and it's over, Mitch. There must have been less than a couple of seconds left. Janet Todd is victorious. Super exhibition from her once again.
Hershey Goto registered his first win in ONE Championship with a dominant display against Ovaya Shaw. Both athletes started out cautiously in this strawweight contest. Hershey Goto came alive in the second round as he moved inside and unleashed hard punches in combination, including one that seemed to wobble his rival. It was more of the same in the final frame. Only this time, Hershey Goto imposed his game plan seconds after the opening bell. A flurry of punches set up another trip takedown, and he was dominant from there. As the contest entered the final 90 seconds, Hershey Goto's offense opened the door for a pass to side control, where he threatened with a tight-looking key lock. Then he moved into full mount and spun for an armbar. Shaw kicked himself free, but he was exhausted, and his opponent resumed his overwhelming striking attack until the final bell. After three rounds of action, Hershey Goto left the Impact Arena with the unanimous decision nod. In the main event, Muay Thai legend and ONE Bantamweight Muay Thai world champion, Nong-O Gaiyanghadao, made his first world title defense. He faced the dangerous Shudo boxing world champion, Hiroaki Suzuki from Japan.
Low kick, he goes up top, mixing the strikes.
Very muscular men at bantamweight. And again, Nong-O goes up. Oh, that was heavy. Heavy blow to the chest. If you haven't seen him before, what is immediately apparent is Nong-O's speed. Right hand from Nong-O and follows it up with a kick. 10-point must system. So this opening round is crucial. And Nong-O almost upends his opponent. Oh, solid. It was square on the jaw. And similarly struck there. Speed at which Nong-O unleashes. Up high on his shoulder blade. Look at the welts there, Mitch. I mean, he's being marked. And he keeps going. The accuracy as well. 44 seconds left of the second round. And Nong-O is putting on an exhibition of kicking here. That right leg working overtime. Oh, and that's finally made him stumble, and it landed in exactly the same spot. How many times has he hit that spot?
He has the ability to throw serious shots with 100% power and not get tired.
It's going to be difficult to do anything useful with that left arm of his.
Because he's just taking a hammering right now. So that hand might be starting to drop a little bit. Nong-O sees it, and now he's starting to go head hunting. But he doesn't seem to be affected too much by it. He's still throwing shots. He's still coming forward.
Like a hamburger now. Combination of the two. 45 seconds left in the fourth round. The almost compulsory, and by the way, it totally isn't, show of respect at the start of that round. Not back off. He's come forward for the entire contest, but now he's getting stopped in his tracks a bit. Nong-O has stepped up the pace, and this crowd are behind him. Every blow goes downstairs as well, and back up, this time to the heads, are slightly higher than the vast majority of his kicks, with that very busy right leg. Spinning back elbow, And Suzuki smiles at him, and you've got to give this Japanese man all the credit. Nong-O rounding off what has been a near perfect performance. Pinpoint accuracy from start to finish. A game plan that was set out and perfectly followed.
And still one Bantamweight Muay Thai World Champion, Nong-O.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.